Hello students, let us continue module 4. In this lecture video, we will be studying last topic of module 4, that is the phased application of security in an operational environment. What is that? It is a security practitioner's goal to safely secure the environment for which he or she is responsible. Suppose if you are working in any platform or any environment or any case, any software, make sure that the software is very secure. It's your responsibility to make the environment secured. For an operational technologist, this process is different because the priorities and effects to be protected are highly differentiated from the better known IT environment. So it's a very, very important for operational technologies. This process is different because with the environment need to be protected based on the priorities and value of effects. If there is one key concept to grasp, it is that security for an IoT environment is an ongoing process in which steps forward can be taken, but there is no true finish line. In the case of security, giving the security to the software or platform, it is ongoing process. Because every day, a new technology is coming, new concept is coming. Today, if we assume if something is secured 100%, but with new technology that can be compromised. Again, if you provide a new security to any other software, it may be in future some technology can come which can compromise the highest degree of secure infrastructure also. As a secure network infrastructure and asset, as a first step, you need to analyze and secure the basic network design. In this case, we need to analyze and secure the basic network design. This figure given below illustrates inter-level security models and inter-zone conduits in the process control hierarchy. It is showing how we can provide the security to the environment or platform in a hierarchy level. You can see that it is divided into level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4 and level 5. Here, this level 0 to 2, it is divided into different zone A and zone B. And it will be control conduit. This is the process, basic control, area control. Then here, site operations and control. Demilitarized zone, site business planning and logistic network, and enterprise network. So here at each level, that security need to be checked and it need to be protected. Data need to be protected if the data is moving from one level to another level. The communication crossing the boundaries of those zones should be secured and controlled through the concept of conduits. So here you can see that if the communication or data it is passing from one zone to another zone, like here zone A, zone B, or here these zone, sorry, it is from here site operations and control, if it is moving to the demilitarized zone, or it is moving to this zone, so enterprise zone, demilitarized zone and operations zone. So if the communication is passing from one zone to another zone, data needs to be checked, it needs to be corrected, it needs to be secured. So that's what it is telling here. The communications crossing the boundary of those zones should be secured and controlled through the concept of conduits. These concepts will be called conduits. So using the conduits, data or communication need to be secure if it is passing, crossing the zone from one zone to another zone. Why? Because when the data can be compromised, when the data is passing from one zone to another zone, and that is the main time when data intruder can hack the data, it can access the communication. Because suppose the intruder will be active in one zone, it may not so active in another zone. So when we are crossing the zone, then only there is a chance for data to become compromised. So when we are crossing the zone, we must make sure that our data or communications are secure. In response to this, it is suggested that a security professional discover the state of his or her network and all communication channels. So, in response to this, it is suggested that a security professional discover the state of his or her network and all communication channels. So, professionals are suggested to find the state of his network channels in the context of security. They must know their channel, how secure their channel are there, and if they are passing data from one channel to another channel, we should also know how secure the other channel it is there where my data is passing through. Okay, so like this we finish the module 4, and we will see in the module 5. Thank you very much.